afternoon, children. So today we are going to be studying something which is very different. It's the first time in grade 6 that we are being introduced to the world of magnets. Now, as soon as something magnets comes to our mind, what's the first thing which comes to our mind is maybe our refrigerator magnets which are stuck, right? What do I have right now is these magnets, right? They also, since our class has a magnetic board, so whatever we are sticking, it gets stuck. So you can see that I have stuck right now three different types of magnets. There is a horseshoe shaped magnet, a ring magnet, and a bar magnet. Now, the world of magnets is really, really, really interesting, because if we see in a daily life scenario, we have n number of things in which we are using magnets, like from our refrigerator, those are doors, all these hinges and all, they are made with magnets. So they are really, really very beneficial to us. Now, when we're talking about magnets, there's also a very important thing which we need to know is poles of the magnet, right? So what are the two poles, the two ends which are having maximum strength? So understanding the poles of the magnet, the strength of the magnet, we will also do many experiments. Now, when we say magnets and their poles, there are two poles, the north pole and the south pole of a magnet. So what happens to the attraction? Right? That is, either the opposite pole, they attract each other, or opposite pole repel each other. To understand this basic attraction principle of the poles of the magnet, we will do a small little interesting activity. Yes, since it's a Christmas time which is very near to us, we will try to understand this with a small little activity. So let's do the activity. So what you can see right now is a small little jungle. And what do we have in this jungle? A little deer, right? It's a Christmas time, children. So what did I do? I had lots of Christmas tree around. And this little deer, it's moving around here and there in search of food, right? It needs to have food, right? So what did he find? He found a piece of meat. Now, it's a deer and he found a piece of meat. So he tries to take the meat, eat the meat. But as we all know that a deer is a herbivorous animal, right? We all know this. So it will never ever take the piece of meat. Just see, what is it doing? It's actually nodding, no, 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 I don't want this piece of meat. So what next? This deer moves to this next portion, which is grass. And yum, it loves the grass and it starts eating it. So isn't that interesting to find that herbivorous animal is also finding its food over here? Now, these are simple paper puppets, right? So definitely it must be driven by some kind of force. And the thing which has been driven is magnetism. The principle over here is magnetism. These are the two poles which we have put over here. These are unlike poles. That is, one of them is a north pole and the other one is a south pole. So unlike poles, what do you see? There's a strong attraction in the unlike poles. Whereas when they were like poles, there was a small, strong repulsion. That's the repulsion we are seeing. That is, this goat is not able to take the meat because the magnets which have stuck is their same poles, right? So that is the reason, children. The simple activity makes us believe that how strong is the force of attraction as well as the force of repulsion. I hope we all learn something different from this activity. Do try it. Thank you so much.